Good morning, children. How are you? Hope you are all at home and being safe. Yes, children. And don't trouble your parents also. Yes, children. So today I'm going to teach you English. You all know my name is Srivalli, teacher. And you may be all wondering what teacher is going to teach today. Which lesson she is going to teach? Yes, children. I know your excitement. Even I am also very excited to teach you something very interesting lesson. Okay, so we will play a small riddle like a puzzle, and guess what lesson we are going to learn today. Okay, the puzzle is I am a small animal. Okay, listen carefully, children. And the puzzle is, I am a small animal. My name starts with M. Letter M. It starts with the letter M. And I like to eat cheese, little small crackers. Any guesses, children? What, which lesson, which animal we are talking about? Any guesses? Let me give you one clue. It has a long tail. Long tail, and it have a sharp teeth also. It always, you know, bite or chew very slowly and very quickly. They nibble things. They nibble like take chewing or eating in a small bites, like with its front teeth. The front teeth are very sharp. Okay, any guesses? I know few of them have guesses, but let me tell you, it is an animal, mouse. Now you got it, children. This is the animal which starts with letter M. It's a small animal, and it like to eat cheese, favorite food. You like cheese? Even I like cheese. I like cheese pizza. Everyone likes pizza, right? So the animal's favorite food is cheese. So now you got it. So now you understood which animal we will talk today. Okay, open your textbooks, lesson 4, page number 30. Lesson 4, and the what lesson we are learning today? We are not story, we are learning about mice. It's a poem. Okay, children. So everyone open page 30, lesson 4, and today we are learning about mice. Teacher, you told me we are learning about mice. How come you gave me the puzzle about mouse? Yes, children, you may be all wondering. I will tell you that. Let me introduce the concept of singular and plural. See, the warm-up exercise I gave you about mouse. When we are talking about a single mouse, we will say mouse. Yes? But in this lesson, there are more than one mouse. So what we call them? If there are more than one, like two mouse, three, four, n number of mouses, we will call it mice. So you all know singular and plural in your previous classes, right, children? So even don't worry about it. If you forgot also, I'll give you a reminder. Singular means when we are talking about a single object or a single thing, it's called singular. When we are talking about more than one object, any object, like say chalk, it's a singular. Now I have a singular chalk. So if I take, let's see, I have taken, how many chalks are there? Three chalks are there. Did I say chalk? No, I said chalks. Yes? First, I said chalk. Later, I said chalks. So, first I took only one chalk. Later, I took three chalks. It's a plural. It is more than one. Understood, children? We will do more about the singular, plural after this explanation of this lesson. Now, we will move to the lesson 4, mice. So I hope everyone opened with the page 30. So now let's do a warm up exercise again. Who am I? Who am I? See, this is a riddles, puzzles, you know, very interesting. I'm a small animal. My name begins with M. I love to eat cheese. I am a mouse. Children, take your pencil and write in your textbook mouse there in the warm up exercise. Hope you have understood the difference between mouse and mice. Mouse is singular, mice is plural. In this poem, the poet is talking about more than one mouse. So that's why it is mice. Understood, children? So hope you have written this answer in the warm up exercise. Now I will start the poem, explanation of poem. Before that, I would like to ask you one question. Do you like mice? Do you like mouse? I don't. If you ask me, I don't like it. Do you like it? I hope most of the people don't like it. Why? They are very naughty. They are explorers. Nicely here, run here and there in the in our houses, right, children? They make a mess. So that's why, you know, I don't like it. But you know, children, in this poem, the poetess, she's a woman. That's why I'm saying she's a poetess. She wrote this poem. Her name is Rose Philman. What is it, children? The poet name is Rose Philman. You don't like mice, I don't like mice, but this poetess likes mice. She wrote in a poem exclusively only for mice. We are going to read it and understand it, the poem, right now. See, there are few people who like mice. For example, Rose Philman. Now I will start reading and explaining the poem. Keep your index finger. This is called index finger. You just keep your finger on the poem and line by line we will read. I think mice are rather nice. Who is I here, children? Is it me? Is it you? Who is I here? I. Here I means Rose Philman. While writing this poem, she started with I. That means here I means Rose Philman. I think mice are rather nice. They are good. She thinks the mice are nice. Moving to the next, their tails are long. See, children, I have drawn a little mice here. Oh, it's cute, no? See, it has a long tail. Their tails are long. Their faces are small. They have a small face. See, people have different sizes of faces, right? Like some are small, some are big. But this animal have a small face. Their faces are small. They haven't any chins at all. Chins means what, children? This is chins. When you are not eating any lunch or a dinner, your mommy will hold your chin. Eat child, or else you won't get energy. She's going to tell you or not. So we have chins. Yes, but it seems the mice doesn't have chins at all. So hope you understood till here. So next we will move to the next stanza. Their ears are pink. Ears. We have ears, right? Like that also, they have ears. Their ears are pink in color. Their teeth are white. They have a very sharp, big teeth. They will nibble with their teeth. They will eat in a small bites with their teeth. Their teeth are white in color. Do you think children and mice are going to brush their teeth with Colgate toothpaste? No. It's just an imagination. The poetess wrote, their teeth are white in color. They run about the house at night. You know, children, usually what the mice will do? They'll run nicely here and there, roam each and every room at night, you know. They mess things, they will drop the things, and they'll make sounds. So that's why, that is the reason I don't like mice. But the poetess says she likes mice. They are very nice. They are very good. She feels that, right? Hope you understood till here. Let me read it again. Their ears are pink. Their teeth are white. They run around the house at night. And now I am moving to the next stanza. They nibble things. I told you children, nibbling. So chewing, eating in a small bites. Like what they do? Okay, just I am showing you example. Let's see the chisak. How they nibble? The front teeth, sharp teeth. They will nibble things. What things do you nibble? Not only cheese, not only crackers, not only food items. Even they nibble cable, wires, plastic things, wood. Everything they will nibble. See, very naughty, no children? They nibble things. They shouldn't touch. Children, we don't touch cable wires. Current is passing, electricity will be passing. We don't touch them, but they don't care. Even they bite that cable wires also. And no one seems to like them much because it does all these things. No one likes, right? Even you don't like, I don't like. But in this poem, the poetess think the rose Filma thinks they are rather nice. They are very good. Moving to the next, but I think mice are nice. Even finally, all these things, describing all these things, how the mice look like, what things they will do, still she feels the mice are nice. Hope you understood this poem, children. Let me read you one more time, how to pronounce, how to read. Yes, children, let me do. I think mice are rather nice. Their tails are long. Their tails are long. Their faces are small. They haven't any chins at all. They don't have any chins. Their ears are pink in color. So, what is the scene in this picture? They are pink in color. Their teeth are white. They run about the house at night. No, roaming, running here and there. They nibble things. Nibble means, you know, chewing or eating in a small bite. Small bites. See, children, while we are eating a biscuit, we don't put the whole biscuit in our mouth, right? We chew them. We bite them in a small pieces. Small bites. Have a small bite. That is called nibble. They nibble things they shouldn't touch. Cheese we can touch, we can eat. But not only food, they will eat plastic items also. They will eat cable wires. Very dangerous for children. And no one seems to like them much. Mostly, most of the people don't like it. But I think mice are nice. Hope you understood, children. See, this is a very nice, excellent poem. You know, practice at home. I'll give you one tip. If you want to remember, if you want to enjoy the poem, you recite like a song. Okay? With the next class, we will try to sing like a song. I will try it my best so that I teach you through a song. Till now, I hope you all understood this poem. In the next session, don't worry about it, I'm going to give a recap of this poem, and we will do all these singular and plural rhyming words, opposites, everything will be done in the next session. So today's homework will be, see children, recitation of poem. So learn the poem orally, not writing orally. You see, try to, if you want to remember, if you want to enjoy the poem, try to recite in a song, like a song. Hope this is, everything is clear for today's session. And again, we will meet in the next session, children. We will learn new things. Okay? You have a good day. Thank you.